A null reference exception error is something that new developers often encounter when working on projects in Unity. These errors occur when attempting to access object variables or members of object variables when the variable itself is null, hence a null reference exception error. Although the cause is simple, null reference exception errors can present themselves in many different ways. As a result, fixing them isn't always as straightforward as following a standard series of steps. In this video, we will explore the various ways a null reference exception error can occur in Unity, as well as how to handle these various situations. One of the most common ways to get the error is when you're trying to access a method or property. Take the following example. It is a code that can be attached to a game object to make it behave like a projectile, making it move towards the right the moment it spawns. If you attach this to any game object in your scene, you will get a null reference exception error. This is because the variable RB has never been assigned a value. So calling RB.velocity here can't work as it's basically calling null.velocity. To rectify this, we will have to ensure that RB is assigned before we try to access its properties. A simple way to do this for our script is to assign the rigid body in void start. Or make the variable public or serializable and assign it in the inspector. Be aware that your game object will need to have a rigidbody2d component for this to work. Otherwise, the get component will return null and you will get a null reference error anyway. Another extremely common way to get the error is to access a destroyed object. Let's take a look at this script. This script allows the game object it's attached to shoot a projectile which self-destructs after 2 seconds using space, and print out the name of the last projectile shot with control. If we press control more than 2 seconds after shooting your last projectile, you will either get a null reference exception or its closely related cousin, a missing reference exception. This is because, although last bullet points to an object, if the object it points to gets destroyed, then the last bullet variable will also become null. To prevent the error messages from happening in such a case, you can add a null check to see if an object variable is null before using it. We can also get the error if we use an unassigned public variable. Let's say we unassign this bullet prefab variable and we fire it. We'll get another cousin of the null reference exception error, the unassigned reference exception error. To fix these errors, the solution is simple. Be sure to assign all the public variables you plan to use. If you want a failsafe in case you forget to assign them, you can include a null check to see if the object variable you want to use is null. Now, not every variable can have a null reference. Primitives such as integers, floats, bools, and structs are value types, not reference types. This means that variables belonging to these two categories are not objects and do not hold references. Hence, they cannot cause null reference exception errors. If you would like to know more about value types, we have an article on that. Link is in the description below. It's important to note that variables of reference types need to be properly initialized and assigned valid object references to avoid the null reference exception and their related errors. By implementing defensive coding practices, performing null checks, and ensuring that you assign variables, you can mitigate the risk of encountering these errors. If you would like to know more about null reference exception errors, check out our article on it. We constantly update the article, so it will always have the most updated information available. Thank you for watching till the end, and we hope you found this video helpful.